Honorable members are informed that those who wish to place the written speeches, you are allowed to place the written speeches on the table of the House. Next speaker is Dr. D.N.V. Sindhil Kumar.
Vanakkam, Chairperson. I would like to draw the kind attention of this House regarding the new coronavirus strain B11529, which has been identified in Botswana, South Africa region, where World Health Organization has classified a new strain as high-risk variant of global concern, which has named the heavily mutated strain as Omicron. It has spread to Australia, Italy, Germany, the Netherlands, Britain, Hong Kong, and Belgium. Because Omicron reportedly has more than 30 spikes, which is double the number of the Delta variant, which makes it potentially more dangerous with a higher risk of reinfection. Since its time of detection, it has outpaced the Delta variant and become the dominant strain in parts of South Africa and is a greater cause of concern, which might have effect on India. Sir, regarding the COVID situation, be it the first phase, second, or the anticipatory third phase, the government's reaction has always been reactive and not proactive. Initially, there were confusions in the travel advisory and proper screening was not done at the airports at the beginning month of Jan-Feb. And suddenly, the Prime Minister appears and he announces a 21-day lockdown with just 4 hours, with no preparation or no prior warning to the common man. And during these 21 days of the lockdown, the people were put into much suffering. There was shortage of PPE, the face shields and masks during the first phase. And there was a breach on the state federalism, because health being a state subject, it was the central government which took the procurement of masks, PPE and other things, which the state should have procured. And the delivery of the kits at the initial phase was not of the standard quality for the doctors and frontline warriors to battle with. It was even at a later stage that the government stopped or banned the export of PPEs which were required in India. Regarding the MP Lads Fund, when all the members had given letters for their specific districts to be covered under the MP Lads, the government had taken an unanimous decision of taking away the MP Lads Fund for 2 years. So what happened was, each member who could have uniformly distributed to all states and all districts, the 534 members of this House could have equally distributed the MP Lads Fund just for the corona cost. We don't have any objection in the government taking away the MP Lads. But if it was used for each district and each constituency, it would have had much more impact. Now we don't know what is the status of the MP Lads which was taken away and for what specific purposes was it used. Sir, regarding the migration of labours, after the India-Pakistan migration, this was seen as and was brought out as the biggest migration of the nation, where thousands and thousands and thousands of migrant labourers were just left alone and they were seen walking with so much of sad stories, small children, ladies and all. And during all this time, what did the government do? What did the Prime Minister do? The Prime Minister was seen feeding the ducks. The Prime Minister was seen posing with the peacocks. Nothing was done to address the common man. That is, the common man was just left to himself. Isn't it the role of the government to take care of its citizens? Isn't it what democracy means? The government, what did it do during the 6 months of lockdown? It had just left its citizens alone. There were corporate shops given for corporate firms. But what about the unorganized sector? What about the street vendor? What about the barber? What about the driver? What about the hotel? What about the restaurants? What about the travel agencies? Who took care of them? For 6 months, there was no support from the government as such. And regarding the financial help, it was not rendered at all to the common man. And regarding the doctors, nurses, healthcare workers, the ambulance drivers, the compounders, the technicians, no help was given to them. And the police personnel who were taking care of the country during the 6 month lockdown. Or the number of deaths that they had faced was reduced and was not given as a proper status. The Indian Medical Association had come out with a proper data and said that the then health minister stated data which he had given, that the number of doctors who had expired due to COVID, there was a vast difference between the two of them. And this all showed the failure of the government. And during the second phase, in spite of repeated warnings during the last session, during the last winter session by almost all the members saying that the second wave is going to come, the government didn't heed to anybody's request. During the November 2020 Health Standing Committee of Health, which I am a member, we had given a warning, stern warning to the government that there is going to be shortage of oxygens and ventilators which the government has to gear up. But there was no voice heard, and ultimately, if the first wave was a shortage of mass PP kits and sanitizers, the second was a shortage of beds, oxygens and ventilators. The second wave came more vigorously, causing stronger effect, deaths even to the young people. All families were affected. All families in India, there was at least one person in the family affected by corona, and among the relatives of the families, there was at least one death in all the families in India. After DMK came to power with the Dravidian principles and ideologies, with Periyar's dream, with Anna's plan, Kalinjar Karunanidhi's execution, and CM M.K. Stalin's delivery of schemes to the last village and the last man, the whole government machinery in Tamil Nadu was focused on controlling the second wave. All ration card holders were given a monetary benefit of rupees 4,000 so that they can have at least one impact financially for them to be supported. As a result of the oxygen generator plants which the government took initiative, now all districts in Tamil Nadu have at least two oxygen plants in each district in Tamil Nadu. And regarding the beds, there are around 300 to 1,000 beds with oxygen supply, extra beds which are readily available for the anticipatory of the third wave. And regarding the vaccination camps, so first we saw a big confusion of vaccination. First, the government came up with saying that the only the frontline workers will be given free dose of delivery of the vaccines. Then, upon insistence, it was then said 65 years. Then, when the states had to go for a procurement of vaccines, then the Supreme Court had to intervene, and it was then decided that the vaccines would be given free to all. And sir, taking the example in Tamil Nadu, vaccines, we have conducted more than 5,000 camps per week around Tamil Nadu, and we have been vigorously going after them. And sir, Tamil Nadu has been an example of giving free vaccination even in private hospital sectors, where under the CSR scheme, even if you, it's not that you will have to take a vaccine shot from the government hospital, you can even have it free from the private sector. So regarding the Chengalpattu HBL vaccination center complex, which has already been established, but it has not been operational. Our chief minister has been consistently asking the central government to open up the vaccination complex, and even given a suggestion that even the Tamil Nadu government will take up this complex and run. But till today, the government has not heeded, and there are words that it is going to be given to a private organization. Schemes implemented in healthcare, which have not even been heard of, even in developed nations, have been implemented in Tamil Nadu. So healthcare reaching to the doorsteps of the common man, where the medicines for 30 days for diabetes and blood pressure, hypertension, are given at the doorsteps of the common man. These schemes are not there even in developed countries. We have been setting role models in health throughout throughout Tamil Nadu, which can be, if implemented throughout India, will stand out as a very outshining nation. So our chief minister is setting the bar high day by day and exceeding expectations. The TN model is to be implemented throughout India. As in just more than 200 days of rule in DMK, the CM, M.K. Stalin, has been voted as the number one chief minister, and Tamil Nadu has risen to the rank of number one state in Tamil Nadu. So last, I would like to bring that during COVID, the farmer agitation which had taken place had taken away 700 lives. I sincerely urge upon the government to give a compensation to the 700 lives as a compensation to them. And special thanks to all the farmers and agriculturists, especially to Punjab farmers and Tamil Nadu state government, for passing resolution to repeal the farm law. So the lesson learnt is, people's protest is stronger and has more value than the government's autocracy, and will have to succumb to people's voice. This is the spirit of Indian democracy. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
இந்த வீடியோ உங்களுக்கு பிடிச்சிருந்தா ப்ளீஸ் லைக் அண்ட் ஷேர் பண்ணுங்க. மறக்காம எங்க சேனலை சப்ஸ்கிரைபும் பண்ணுங்க.